potato masher is the grenade that you will find in general use among the Germans. The head consists of a thin iron casing filled with explosive. It is screwed on the wooden handle, through the center of which runs a double length of cord. One end of the cord is attached to a lead ball, which is part of the friction igniter system. At the other end is a porcelain ball, which is exposed by unscrewing the metal cap on the lower end of the handle.
One of the most iconic weapons of the Second World War and most recognizable pieces of ordnance of all time is the German Model 24 steel hand granate. Today, we are going to take a look at the history and function of this indispensable German grenade. To say the very least, World War I had some interesting grenades. Many of them were unreliable, difficult to manufacture, or underpowered. Germany entered the war with the Kugelhandgranate, a segmented cast iron ball that was fit with either a mechanical or burning fuse. The Kugel had several problems, the most important being its weight and the large amount of shrapnel it produced. The weight made it difficult to throw, but why was excess shrapnel a problem? Well, you must understand that there are two types of grenades, offensive and defensive. Defensive grenades are used when you are defending a position, typically a pillbox or trench, and have the ability to take cover to prevent friendlies from getting injured by the explosion. Offensive grenades are used when assaulting a position. The grenades would be thrown out in front of the advancing troops. This type of grenade did not rely on shrapnel, but rather the concussive blast of the explosion itself to do its job. While manufactured as an offensive grenade, the steel hand granate could be converted to defensive, but we will get to that later on. The first version of this famous grenade appeared in 1915. It had a large head that was made up of multiple pieces of sheet steel crimped together and filled with explosive compound. The wooden handle was hollow, with a pull cord hanging out of the bottom and being secured by a paper band. A metal clip was affixed to the side of the head, which allowed it to be carried on the belt. The 1915 model had several problems, but the most notable was the exposed hole in the bottom of the handle. This would allow moisture to enter the grenade and damage the fuse and detonator. The pull cord also tended to get snagged on items and unintentionally detonate the grenade. These issues were remedied in 1916 with the introduction of a new model. This version introduced a metal cap that screwed onto the end of the stick, both to seal up this hole and contain the pull cord. The final major upgrade came in 1917, when the explosive compound was replaced with a newer, more powerful version. This meant that less was required to achieve the desired effects, so the head of the grenade could be smaller. This smaller head was also able to be manufactured from one stamping instead of several parts crimped together. The easiest way to tell this model from the previous ones is to look for the lack of a crimp on the top of the head. After the war ended, Germany was required to destroy the vast majority of their millions of existing grenades. A handful of World War I grenades were kept around, but no new models were manufactured until 1924. As Germany began to slowly rearm itself, it was decided that the production of grenades would resume. In 1924, the latest variant was introduced, which closely resembled the construction of the 1917 model, but with an updated fuse and explosive charge. Production of the Model 24 continued through late 1944, with gradual changes to its design made along the way. And most of these design changes were efforts to simplify production so grenades could be produced quicker and with less material. A couple examples of this are the pressing of threads into the head as opposed to cutting them and removing the spring-loaded washer from the safety caps. The famous white text on the head of the grenade would also be removed in 1940. This text, by the way, means before use insert detonator. So how did these grenades work? First, I should mention that the M24s were shipped from the factory without the detonator or fuse. The soldier would have to take apart the grenade and insert these in the field. To use the grenade, the safety cap would be unscrewed, which allowed the string and porcelain ball to dangle out of the bottom of the handle. The soldier would grab hold of the ball and yank it and the string out of the handle. This would pull the metal wire of the friction igniter and start the fuse. Once the fuse had burned all the way through, normally about 4.5 seconds, it would set off the detonator and explode the grenade. As the war progressed and the situation for Germany became more dire, an even simpler design was needed, so in 1944 the M43 was introduced. The handle was now a solid piece of wood, no longer containing the fuse and pull cord. The fuses for the M43 were borrowed from the egg hand grenade and now mounted on the top of the head. Much like the M24, the most common fuse used on the M43 would burn for 4.5 seconds. These fuses were colored blue, but other fuses with shorter or longer delays could also be used. Because of the self-contained nature of this grenade, the stick could be unscrewed and the head thrown without it. Production of the M43 continued until the end of the war. Part of the success of the M24 was its versatility. What started life as an offensive grenade could easily be converted to defensive use. Two types of removable fragmentation sleeves, called splinterings, were created to increase the amount of shrapnel upon detonation. The first type was a completely smooth cylinder that was held onto the head of the grenade by friction. The second type was stamped with a pattern so that when it exploded, square-shaped fragments would fly in every direction. This type was held onto the grenade by a ring and hook system. Probably the most famous alternative use for the steel hand grenade was as a concentrated charge. To create one, the heads of a number of grenades, normally six, would be removed from their handles and secured around a grenade with its fuse and detonator intact. This would allow the grenades to be used in demolition or anti-tank roles. Now, contrary to what you might think, this was an official method and shows up in a number of training manuals and films. Now, before I wrap up this video, I want to show you two cousins of the M24, the training grenade and the Nebelhandgranate 24. The reusable training grenades would have had a small black powder charge in their heads that would be vented through the holes as to not damage the grenade, but they did use the same fuse as standard grenades. Finally, here is the smoke-generating Nebelhandgranate. It had a series of 8 holes underneath its head to allow for smoke to escape. It used a different fuse and detonator than the M24. If you look at the stick, you can see a white band for quick identification during the day, and raised bands turned into the wood for night. You would obviously not want to mix up a standard grenade with a smoke grenade. Well, thanks for watching this video about the history of the German stick grenade. I hope you enjoyed it. If you would like to see more videos like this, please consider subscribing. Thank you.